Inshallah, I came across some benefits, inshallah, so I wanted to, inshallah, give it to the people, inshallah. Now, I wanted to talk about some mawaqif that the Salaf encountered in poverty and hardship towards finding means to eat. And then some of them selling their clothes and their beds and their house properties in order to just live their day-to-day life. And but how these people were ulama and how they were scholars and people who were high. Al-Imam al-Nawawi rahimahullah. But before I mention this, I feel like هذا الجانب, this point of being poor and poverty, يعد أوسع الجوانب في هذه الطريقة في طلب العلم. That this path in seeking knowledge, poverty plays a big role. لأن إذ كان الفقر شعار العلماء ودثارهم على الغالب فيما مضى من الزمن. The scholars before poverty was their sign. They were known to be poor. It was their behavior. It was their lifestyle. And that's how they became scholars. Imam al-Nawawi in his Kitab al-Majmu' Imam al-Nawawi says in his great book full of benefits, Babu chaptering, Adabu al-Mutalim, the chapter of the one that's learning. And then he brings قول of Imam al-Shafi'i. قال الشافعي رحمه الله, Imam al-Shafi'i said, لا يطلب أحد هذا العلم بالملك وعز النفس فيفلح. No one seeks the knowledge, this knowledge, بِالْمُلْكِ with kingdom, وَعِزِّ النَّفْسِ and an honorable soul, فَيُفْلِحْ and then he becomes successful. It's impossible that a person is a king and he's what? He's an honorable person and then he becomes successful in seeking knowledge. This is not right. It doesn't work like that. وَلَكِنْ but مَنْ طَلَبَهُ بِذُلِّ النَّفْسِ but if the person he seeks knowledge with humiliating himself and his soul, وضيق العيش and hardship in terms of his provision and his means, وخدمة العلماء and serving the scholars, أفلح, he finds success. And he also said, لا يدرك العلم إلا بالصبر على الذل, that one will not seek, one will not gain the success of knowledge until he becomes patient with humiliation. And he also said, لا يصلح طلب العلم إلا لمفلس. That Shafi'i رحمه الله also said, لا يصلح طلب العلم, لا يصلح طلب العلم إلا لمفلس. No one is for him knowledge except the person who is bankrupt. فقيل ولا الغني المكفي, even the rich one who has his sufficient lifestyle is not for him. وَلَا الْغَنِيُّ الْمُكَفِّي. When Shafi'i was asked, he said, no. This knowledge is for a person who's bankrupt. He has nothing. Imam Malik ibn Anas said, and I'm still reading the book Al-Imam al-Nawawi wrote, Al-Majmu'. Imam Malik said, Ibn Anas, لَا يَبْلُغُ أَحَدٌ مِّنْ هَذَا الْعِلْمِ مَا يُرِيدُ حَتَّى يُضِرَّ بِهِ الْفَقْرُ. That one will not reach what he wants in this religion and in this knowledge. He will not reach what he wants in this knowledge until when, حتى يضر به الفقر, until poverty harms him, ويؤثره على كل شيء, and it affects him in all his affairs. And so قول Imam Malik, Abu Hanifa رحمه الله said, يستعان على الفقه بجمع الهم, that it is used and supported with fiqh, بجمع الهم, with a person bringing his aspirations together. ويستعان على حذف العلائق بحذف اليسير عند الحاجة. And the way to do that is that the person takes what is sufficient for him. نعم. ولا تزيد. And do not increase in it. So the person, richness and money, it busies the student's mind. Whereas poverty doesn't. This is what the ulama had took from it. الإمام الحافظ ابن الذهبي, I have his book Tadhkirat al-Hufaz with me right now. When he's mentioning the tarjama, the biography of Nadhr ibn Shumayl, al-Maziniyyu al-Basri, who is a Basri. He was a alim ahlu Marw. He was the scholar of the people of Marw. And he was the student of Khalil ibn Ahmad al-Farahidi. Khalil ibn Ahmad al-Farahidi was the sheikh of Imam al-Sibawi. Ahmad ibn Khalil al-Farahidi al-Lughawi. He was the sheikh of al-Imam al-Sibawi. So Nadhr ibn Shumayl, his tarjama, his biography, when Zahabi is mentioned in his kitab, Tadhkirat al-Hufaz, he says, قال داود بن مخراق سمعت النضر بن شميل. داود ابن مخراق says سمعت I heard نضر بن شميل يقول I heard نضر بن شميل say لا يجد الرجل the man will not find لذة العلم the sweetness of knowledge حتى يجوع وينسى جوعه that the person will not taste the sweetness of knowledge until he feels hungry, and then he forgets his hungriness. So how much he's seeking knowledge, he forgets that he's hungry. Allahu Akbar. Yaqut al-Hamawi, his Mu'jam al-Udaba. I've got the 12th volume open for me, 239. He mentions fi tarjamat al-Imam al-Hafiz al-Faqih al-Mujtahid al-Mutafannin. He talks about the great Muhaddith, the great Faqih, the great Usuli, the great Mufassir, the great Mujtahid, Ibn Hazm al-Zahiri, Ali ibn Ahmad al-Andalusi al-Qurtubi. Imam al-Qurtubi, Imam ibn Hazm, he and Abu Walid al-Baji, Abu Walid Sulaiman ibn Khalaf al-Baji, both of them met each other. So Ibn Hazm met Abu Walid al-Baji. وجرت بينهما مناظرة. A debate occurred between them two. فلما انقضت قال الفقيه. When the debate was over, Abu Walid al-Baji stood up and he said to Ibn Hazm, تعذرني فإن أكثر مطالعتي. Excuse me. For the majority of my researches كانت على سرج الحراسي. It was under a dim light, a candle. It wasn't something good. I was seeking knowledge with a dim candle. Ibn Hazm then said, وَتَعْذُرُنِي أَيْضًا and excuse me, فَإِنَّ أَكْثَرَ مُطَالَعَتِي and majority of my researching كَانَتْ عَلَى مَنَائِرِ الذَّهَبِ وَالْفِضَّةِ أي عَلَى الْمَصَابِيحِ الْمَصْنُوعَةِ مِنَ الذَّهَبِ وَالْفِضَّةِ Ibn Hazm is saying, as for me, excuse me, for the majority of research I did it from candles that were made out of gold and silver. The scholars, they mentioned why Ibn Hazm asked for forgiveness and why he asked to be forgiven for what he had said. Yaqut al-Hamawi, who's the man who brought the story, he says, أراد أن الغنى أضيع لطالب علم من الفقر. Ibn Hazm chose to say that because richness and having money, and you know, as you all know, Ibn Hazm his father was a minister. So it was from a very rich family. Whereas Abu Walid al-Baji was poor. So Yaqut al-Hamawi is saying, the reason why Ibn Hazm is asking for forgiveness is because he seeks knowledge through richness. And richness forsakes a student from seeking knowledge. Meaning it distracts him from seeking knowledge. Whereas poverty and hunger doesn't do that to you. It doesn't do that to you. Well, and because of that, we find that people today, they don't seek knowledge as those scholars used to seek knowledge. لماذا? And the reason is known is because كثرت المشاغل. The majority, they get distracted by a lot of things. Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal said, as Imam al-Hafiz ibn Kathir mentions in the Kitab al-Bidayah wa Nihaya, the 10th volume, page 330, he says, in the tarjama of Imam Ahmad, قال أحمد ibn Hanbal, الإمام المبجل, إمام أهل السنة والجماعة بلا مدافع said الصبر على الفقر مرتبة لا ينالها إلا الأكابر. Patient on poverty is a status. No one gains it except a person who's great, who's noble. والفقر أشرف من الغنى. And poverty is more honorable than richness. فإن الصبر patience عليه on poverty Mararatun. It doesn't taste nice. It's hard. وَانْعِزَاجَهُ أَعْظَمُ حَالًا مِنَ الشُّكُرِ. And the means to ask Allah and thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is always closer and it's better. وَلَا أَعْدِلُ بِفَضْلِ الْفَقْرِ شَيْئًا. Ahmad is saying, I will not choose any alternative over poverty for richness. وَكَانَ أَحْمَدْ يُحِبُّ التَّخَفُّفَ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا. Ahmad used to love, Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal used to love, that the person takes it easy in the dunya. لِأَجْلِ خِفَّةِ الْحِسَابِ. So the account, because the accountability, the day of judgment can be easy for you. وَلِذَلِكَ الْإِمَامُ حَافِظِ ابْنُ الْجَوْزِي in his kitab Manaqil Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal, I went back to it to check what he has said. Maybe he said something like that as well. And also Ibn Muflih said something like that in his kitab Adab al-Shar'iyya, that Imam Abu Bakr al-Maruzi, he said, I heard Ahmad ibn Hanbal say, مَا أَعْدِلُ بِالْفَقْرِ شَيْئًا. I cannot exchange anything for poverty. مَا أَعْدِلُ بِالْفَقْرِ شَيْئًا. I cannot exchange anything for poverty. أَنَا أَفْرَحُ إِذَا لَمْ يَكُنْ عِنْدِي شَيْءٍ. I am happy when I have nothing with me. وَكَانَ يُحِبُّ الْفُقَرَى. Ahmad used to love the people who were poor. لَمْ أَرَى الْفَقِيرُ فِي مَجْلِسٍ أَحَدٍ أَعَزُّ مِنْهُ فِي مَجْلِسِ. Imam ibn Muflih and Imam ibn Jawzi both said, there was no one, because they're narrating the speech from Abu Bakr al-Maruzi, that Abu Bakr al-Maruzi said that I never saw poor people who were honorable in a gathering the way they were honorable in the gathering of Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal rahimahullah. And this is why a person will gain knowledge. As the Sha'ir said, وَمَنْ اسْطَبِرْ لِلْعِلْمِ يَغْفَرْ بِنَيْلِهِ وَمَنْ يَخْطُ بِالْحَسْنَاءَ يَصْبِرُ عَلَى الْبَذْلِ وَمَنْ لَمْ يُبَذِّلِ النَّفْسَ وَمَنْ لَمْ يُذِلَّ النَّفْسَ فِي طَلَبِ الْعُلَى يَسِيرًا يَعِشْ دَهْرًا طَوِيلًا أَخَا ذُلِّي وَمَنْ يَصْبِرْ لِلْعِلْمِ. Anyone who is patient, يَصْطَبِرْ لِلْعِلْمِ, he is very patient for knowledge, يَظْفِرْ بِنَيْلِهِ, he will bring every means to gain it. نعم. وَمَنْ يَخْطُ بِالْحَسْنَاءَ يَصْبِرْ عَلَى الْبَذْلِ. If a man wants to marry a beautiful, attractive girl in which his heart is full, or a girl wants to marry a guy who's very charming, she will do all means to get him. The same way the man will put everything to the table. Whether she says her dowry is 50,000, he will put it to the table. Whether he will put everything in order to get her. In this way as also, the Sha'ir is saying, when the knowledge should be like that, when the person loves it. وَمَنْ لَمْ يُذِلَّ النَّفْسَ فِي طَلَبِ الْعُلَى. Anyone who does not humiliate himself for seeking knowledge, يَسِينٍ a little bit, يَعِشْ دَهْرًا, he will live for a long time. دَهْرًا a time, طَوِيلًا for a long time, أَخَى ذُلِّنْ a person who is humiliated. He will live for a long time humiliated. نعم. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us the mean and the effort to seek knowledge the way He is pleased with. And that everything that we seek, Allah doesn't make it a hujjah against us, but rather Allah makes it the hujjah for us. Wallahi, Allah is the only one who is able to do that for us. I conclude there. Subhanaka Allahumma bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa Allah. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.